Kia ora, good evening. Time's up for our border workers to be vaccinated, with at least 9 being fired for refusing the jab. The workers all had their fixed-term contracts with customs terminated early as redeployment to non-frontline positions wasn't an option. It comes as more vaccination clinics open and the government sets its sights on large-scale venues to boost numbers. May Heron has more.
Once a Noel Leeming store, now refitted for a different purpose.
Come and chick, chick, and they're out. It's pretty cool.
Starting tomorrow, these seats will be full of people getting vaccinated. But venues like this are hard to find. Accessibility and location crucial.
It's right on bus rail lines and it's in the middle of Westgate and New Lynn, which are two big hubs.
Do you have a translator?
This clinic in Ōtāra opened 3 weeks ago, vaccinating up to 300 people a day. It's working hard to reach everyone in the community.
Yesterday we had our youth team who actually went out and picked up our elderly folks in these homes. They'll come in to get their vaccine done and also have morning tea.
So far, over 100,000 New Zealanders have had their first dose, over 60,000 their second. But not everyone's so keen, and for frontline workers, the consequences have been severe. 9 unvaccinated staff working for customs fired. A lawyer representing 4 of them says their risk of catching the virus is low and the law needs to be re-examined.
Nursing homes are going to start worrying what to do, and you've got preschool teachers and all these other industries are going to think, OK, well, how do we do? And they're looking at the government for advice.
Border and MIQ workers have been getting vaccinated since February. High-risk frontline workers and those living in high-risk places such as rest homes since March. And soon we'll be vaccinating Group 3, those who are at risk of getting very sick from COVID should get an invitation from their local DHB later this month. Everyone else can expect to be vaccinated from July. Pamphlets have also been sent out. Doctors say the next 6 weeks are crucial as more and more people get the jab.
I personally have been asked a lot of questions by patients about the vaccine, the safety of the vaccine, where they'll get it, how they'll get it, and what will happen. So there's a huge amount of interest out there.
But the Ministry of Health wouldn't be interviewed about the next stages, saying it may cause confusion. However, One News understands venues like Eden Park will be meeting with ministers in the coming weeks. Assigned stadiums may be used as large-scale vaccination hubs.
It's critical that we gear up where the population can get vaccinated, and that will be a mix of general practice and other vaccination centres within New Zealand.
Venues of all shapes and sizes will be needed to boost vaccination numbers. May Heron, One News.